got some questions now about the song One Day at a Time.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of fans don't know when this song was recorded. Was it before or after Tupac joined Death Row Records?
That was after Tupac. That was 2 weeks before he died.
Really? Wow. So the song was recorded in 96.
Mm-hmm.
Can you remember where the song was recorded? Was it in the Can-Am studios?
Not at all. It was at Ice-T's house, up at the Crack House. We call it the Crack House, Sunset Plaza. Same house that was on MTV's, MTV Cribs.
The song was released on an album from Spice One in 2004. And was this the real original version?
Yeah, but I didn't know Spice was releasing it.
Because there's a rumor that Spice One re-recorded this first for the version in 2004.
Exact words you said, re-recorded it.
So the original first was just the same, but just a different recording?
No, it's the same thing. Spice just different rap. Just Spice just put a verse on it.
Spice One originally didn't have a verse on it?
No, not at all. Tupac, wow. It was just Tupac. And then I let my friends rap on it, LP and Spice.
Okay, so Tupac originally recorded this as a solo track.
By himself, he did the first verse. We didn't get to the second because he had to do his movie also with the Gridlock. You know, he was doing Gridlock exactly at that time. He had to go.
And Spice One and LP's verses were recorded later on, after his death?
Yeah, later on, after, yeah, exactly.
Okay, and the instrumental, is that the real original instrumental?
Yes.
Oh, that's dope. How you came with the idea of this beat?
Same thing I was telling you up front, the 80s R&B type vibing songs, when Sheryl Lynn was out and Chaka Khan and that type of vibe, and I just put today's drum sounds underneath it and some kicks, and it's basically the same vibe of the 80s rhythm and soul type vibe with the singing.
Mm-hmm. And do you have some information about the other rapper? His name is LP?
Yes. He's a good rapper, you know. We used to be in the same, he used to be in my production company. He used to have his too, Rhymestone. And he's a good friend. He's very talented. He was actually my artist.
Okay, nice. And who is the guy that was doing the hooks in the song?
That was Chris. What group was that? Headstrong, a group called Headstrong.
And the name of the song on the Spice One album was You Gotta Take It. Is this the original name of the song?
No. It's called One Day at a Time.
Okay, so maybe Spice One took a different name for it?
Not maybe, definitely.
Okay, yeah. And this is the only song that you produced for Tupac, right?
Mm-hmm.
And is there a reason for that?
Died 2 weeks after. And he was underneath, really deep under, you know, the umbrella of his Death Row situation. So he was dealing with a lot of producers over there. You know how it is when people have cliques? You know, we were associated doing our Ice-T thing, and he was doing his Death Row thing, but we were still friends.
And in 2003, Amaru Records released a remix of One Day at a Time on the Tupac Resurrection soundtrack. And do you like what Eminem did with the track?
It sounded like Eminem. It was cool. It was cool. It was banging in the club. You see the vibe that we had with the original version was different.
Yeah.
It was originally what Tupac rapped on.